Sheave blocks are available with single or multiple sheaves, a variety of head fittings and different materials. Below is a selection of some of the most common types. Single sheave blocks are used to change direction of a hoisting or pulling rope wire. Multiple sheave blocks are used to reduce the pull required for a lift. The resulting force applied on the block head depends upon the angle between the ropes and the friction in the sheaves. The friction force to be added to the calculation is usually, for sheaves with roller bearings, 4% per sheave. For sheaves with bronze brushes, 8% per sheave. The table below provides the factor to be used for calculation of the resulting pull and weight force. To calculate the resulting force, use the following formula. Weight, friction, factor. Use this table to find the resulting head load, R, and the required pull, P, when lifting a weight, W. Multiply the weight to be lifted, W, by the factors indicated to find the required pull, P, and or resulting head load, R. Divide your line pull capacity, P, by the weight to be lifted, W, and compare with factors to find block type and SWL required. The following checks must be made before the use of sheave blocks. SWL must be adequate. Examine sheaves for cracks, wear or distortion. Spin sheaves and ensure smooth operation. Examine housing and head fittings for cracks, wear and distortion. Check the operation and condition of all parts of head fittings. Make sure grease nipples are open and clean and blocks well lubricated. Make sure there are no sharp edges or burrs on the side plates that can damage the wire or rope. Check that the rope groove is compatible with the wire or rope. Always make sure that the support structure is strong enough to support the resulting head load. Make sure the sheave block is correctly aligned to avoid the rope abrading on the side plates.